All right, what's up everyone? How you all doing? My name is Chris and I make videos about fitness, lifestyle, and entrepreneurship. And today is gonna be a fitness focused video. I wanna give you some tips for how to bulk up and gain muscle while minimizing fat gain. So when I started my bulking journey, I was like around 100 pounds and I bulked pretty rapidly. I think in like 5-6 months, I put on about 40 plus pounds, but I was keeping fat gain down to a minimum. Here's something you need to understand with bodybuilding and dieting and bulking. It's gonna be different for everyone, right? Some people can gain weight and build muscle at a much faster pace than others, whereas other people might need to go more slow because they gain fat more easily. This is where your genetics come into play. And what I recommend doing is figuring out what works best for you and going with that. What works for one person might not work for someone else. So here's how you get started. Figure out how much calories you need to eat to maintain your current weight. And the way you can do this is by just counting your calories for a couple days, you know, whatever you're eating on a regular basis to maintain your current weight. You could use a tracker like MyFitnessPal, that's what I've done, and figure out where that is. That's your baseline, that's your maintenance calories. I would start by increasing your calories maybe 200 to 500 per day, okay? So a 200 to 500 calorie surplus. Monitor your weight for 1 to 2 weeks and see how you do. Generally, the rule of thumb is to aim for 0.5 to 1 pound per week. But here is where I think it needs to be more individualized. At the very beginning, that's a good starting point. You don't want to be gaining too fast because then you could accumulate more fat than muscle, which you don't want. Once you figure out how your body is responding to the training and the calorie surplus, for instance, if you find you can gain more rapidly while minimizing fat gain, then obviously do that. So if you want to eat in an even higher surplus, adjust accordingly. But you want to start off slow and evaluate your results. See how you are doing, you know, for the first month and then go from there. So I recommend starting with 200 to 500 calories and then adjusting accordingly. And of course, you shouldn't go just based off what the scale says. Also, look at yourself in the mirror. See how you feel you look. Do you think you're getting bigger? Take measurements. I would say weigh yourself maybe just once per week. Weight fluctuates daily, so you really don't need to do it every day. And I would recommend, you know, first thing in the morning, after going to the bathroom, before eating or drinking anything, wearing very light clothing so you're not, you know, adding extra weight. You're trying to really get your actual body weight. Now let's talk about training. So training, again, just like with the nutrition and everything else, you got to figure out what works best for you. What works for one person isn't going to necessarily work for someone else. Try different things out, different rep schemes, different types of training, and figure out what works best for you in terms of getting bigger, gaining muscle and strength. And obviously you want to be putting in that effort. You can't just half-ass your workouts and eat in a surplus and expect you're going to build muscle. You need to put in the work. You need to be striving to be increasing the weight, the reps, making progress. My approach to fitness and bodybuilding is very individualized. I think you have basic principles and concepts that are great. It's a good way to get someone started. But once you get going, once you gain more experience, you really want to learn how your body is responding to training, to the nutrition, and then tailor your plan to how your body responds, how your body works. Learn about your own self. And that just comes with experience. Now, what should you eat? You might have heard the term clean bulk versus dirty bulk. If it fits your macros, can you eat whatever the fuck you want as long as you stay within your calorie intake? Here's something that you need to understand. It's not just about building muscle and gaining weight. It's also about your health, right? So sure, you could eat 3,000 calories of crap all day and gain weight and build some muscle, but fitness isn't just about looking good. Don't you want to feel good? Don't you want to improve your health, improve your overall quality of life? So being mindful of what you eat. You know, even if you are trying to gain weight and everything, try to get the majority of your calories from good quality foods. Do you need a weight gainer? I never took one, and I was eating 5,000 plus calories a day. What I recommend instead is if you have trouble getting a lot of calories in, you know, maybe you just feel full or whatnot, You can make your own homemade mass shakes using oatmeal, fruit, protein powder, natural peanut butter, whole milk. You don't need to invest in weight gainers and stuff like that. Supplements. When I first started bulking, I kind of got wrapped up into thinking I needed all these different supplements and whatnot. And you get a lot of stuff from food if you eat good quality foods. The only thing I really take is fish oil, a multivitamin. I have the protein powder that I use for shakes and stuff, but protein powder isn't necessary. It's optional. Creatine, I don't load or cycle, just 5 grams every single day, and pre-workout. But that's a personal, pre-workout's personal choice. There again, none of this stuff is really necessary, but you know, creatine has data and science back behind it as far as the results. Protein powder obviously can be another source of protein, way to get some extra calories in. Fish oil, multivitamin, stuff's good for you. So that's kind of what I take. Is there other stuff that you can take that might be beneficial? Sure, I recommend doing your research, but really what it comes down to is nutrition, training, sleep, and rest. Which brings me into the last point, your recovery. Recovery is important. It is the time when you're building muscle, your body's repairing itself. How much recovery you need varies from person to person. I train 6 days on with 1 day off. Sometimes I'll even go in and do like abs or something on the day off. For another person, that might be too much. You might need, say, 2 or 3 days off. How much sleep you need can vary from person to person as well. Obviously, the general recommendation is usually 7-8 hours, but you've got people who can do fine on, say, 5 to 6 hours. It really depends on you, but make sure you're taking time to recover and getting enough sleep. Listening to your body, that's the best indicator as to whether you need to recover or not. If you're getting burned out from training and everything, you're gonna feel it. And, you know, 1 day of being sore or tired doesn't mean you shouldn't train or that you're burnt out. But maybe say feeling sore and tired for a while consecutively, multiple days in a row, could be a sign that you need to change things up, maybe back off a little bit. And obviously that's where planning recovery weeks or deloads into your training cycle can help, but that's a whole nother discussion. So that's going to conclude this video. I hope you guys found it helpful. I'd love to hear your comments and your thoughts. If you'd like to support me and the channel, please consider giving the video a like, subscribing, sharing it, turning it on notifications so you're notified of my next video, and I'll see you guys next time. Thanks so much for watching.